So, sekarang kita discuss elektromagnet kan. So untuk tahu electromagnetic spectrum tadi, kita kena ingat dia punya acronym, which is RADI, ME, X, girlfriend.
No. Answer C.
So the answer is C. Okay, the answer is C because yang kita ada micro, okay, ME, RADI tak ada. So kita ada micro, ME, infrared, I, lepas tu visit tak ada, visible light tak ada, ultraviolet ada, X-ray tak ada, gamma. Okay, so kita hafal tu, RADI, may I visit your ex-girlfriend? Radio, micro, infrared, visible light, UV, X-ray, gamma. Okay, so ini soalan lebih kurang macam tadi, the properties of electromagnetic wave. So first, electromagnetic wave are field wave. So ni salah because this one is only sound wave, longitudinal wave. Okay, propagate at 300 meter per second. No, it propagate at 3 times 10 power of 8 meter per second, which is speed of light. Okay, semua electromagnet tadi in vacuum move in the speed of light, 3 times 10 power of 8. Okay, C pula, electromagnetic wave undergo reflection, diffraction and interference. This is correct. Because macam cikgu beritahu, semua wave yang korang belajar, light wave, water wave, electromagnet, sound wave, semua undergo these four phenomena. So C is correct. Eh, oh dah dapat jawapan lah. Okay, so D pula, electromagnetic wave consists of electric field and magnetic field. Ni betul, tapi kat sini salah. Oscillating parallel, salah. Dia oscillates perpendicular. So ni atas bawah. Okay, the magnetic field, and then we have electric field. Okay, kanan. Alright. Okay, so jawapan dia kat sini, SPM 2010 ni, C. Okay, so yang ni pula. Ultraviolet can be used to UV. UV boleh guna untuk apa?
Detect counterfeit notes.
Detect counterfeit money. Okay, destroy cell cancer, gamma. Okay, gamma irradiation. Okay, determine ocean depth, ultra sound. Check baggage.
X-ray.
Yelah, X. Yang dekat airport tu, yang masuk bag tu, tu X-ray lah tu. Kalau rasa malas nak pergi hospital, bolehlah tu masuk. Masuk jalan kan, dapat X-ray. Cuma tak ada gambar.
X-ray dia dangerous ke untuk kita?
Kalau lama, yes. Sebab tu kalau korang pergi hospital, korang pergi klinik, dia kalau bila X-ray tu, bila ada orang masuk, dia akan tukar lampu merah. Dia cakap jangan masuk. And then kalau korang perasan bila nak X-ray, contoh korang nak X-ray badan ke, dia hanya tutup dekat badan je. So, dia tak nak bagi semua. Because dia can... X-ray boleh bunuh korang punya sel, macam skin cell, boleh mati. Sebab tu bila korang buat X-ray, most of the time akan dapat MC. Dia bagi MC untuk rehat, untuk regenerate balik sel-sel yang mati. Okay, oh. So
tunggu, kalau nak buat X-ray lagi kena tunggu 1 atau 2 minggu
kot. Eh tak, X-ray tak silap cikgu, kalau kalau yang macam kes kat hospital tu, jantung terpaksa lah. Tapi kalau macam kita just untuk medical check up, I think 6 months
after. Ha? 6 months? Banyak? Panjangnya?
Kalau macam kita medical check up, untuk medical check up kan, you do the medical check up, the X-ray boleh tahan untuk setahun tak, cikgu? It can be used. Unless kalau kita ada macam accident ke apa kan, tu lain lah. Tapi kalau kita nak guna for medical check up, nak register university ke register sekolah ke yang minta medical check up, you can use the X-ray for a year. Guna same X-ray.